Hello everyone, welcome to Code and Learn. If you aren't already aware, Go version 1.24 has been released. So in this video, we are going to update our project to use Go version 1.24 and also use the tool directive. Let's first update the Go version. In here, I can just manually update it to say that now we are going to use 1.24, save it. Another place that we want to change it is in the Docker file. For this, I will say 1.24.0, save it again, and that's it. We have updated the Go version for our module or our project. Now I updated this project because we want to use the new Go tool directive that has been introduced with Go 1.24. So let's do that. Just to recap, if you remember, we were using the tools.go pattern to install tools for our project. In this case, we were installing mockgen in a bin to generate mocks from interfaces like we have in the handler. This is what we were doing. So let's first delete this. Now the tools file has been deleted. We were installing the tools using the tools target in our makefile. At line 27, we were grepping all the dependencies from our tools.go file to install it in our Go bin. So instead of doing that, we are going to rely on the tool directive. Now to add the tool directive, I'm going to use the go tool command. We need to install the mockgen tool. So I'm going to do go get dash tool and the module name, and that's it. Now if you see at the bottom of the go.mod file, we have the tool directive added. Just to make sure everything is working, I'm just going to do go mod tidy. Now back to our make file, we can remove this, that is getting and grepping, and just do go install tool like this. We want to specify the go bin because we want to keep dependencies installed in the local bin, and then run make tools. You will see that mockgen has been installed in the .bin directory like before, but now we are relying on the tool command instead of using the tools.go file. You can install other tools similarly. If you want to use the tool, you can just do go tool and specify the name of the tool. Just for example, let's do go tool mockgen. Since mockgen requires different flags, it is just printing the help information. But if you wanted to run other tools, you can just do go tool and then specify the name of the tool like this. Now to list all the installed tools for our project, we can just do go tool and it will list all the tools that our project is using. These are internal tools used by Go, and then at the end you will see we will have mockgen, that is a tool we added. Similar to this, we can also update our tools using the go tool flag. So we can do go get minus u or dash u and then tool. This will update all the tools that we have. These are the tools that Go is internally using. Let's run go mod tidy, clean everything up, and that's it. I'm going to commit this and say go version and tools update. So that's it for this video. Just to recap, in this video what we did was update the Go version for our module to 1.24. Then we used the tool directive to install the tool that our projects rely on, updating our makefile to install the tools using go install tool. That's it for this video. I hope you enjoyed it. If you have any questions, please post a comment under the video or reach out to our Discord server. Until next time, happy coding.